Andrew McCart, IFL TV in association with MDK Global. I'm here with Jack Turner. You were a wee bit we were talking off camera just out the ring there. You're a wee bit disappointed in yourself with that performance. Why is that?
Just not really disappointed, just good. I'm happy I'm back in there, that's it. I'm just happy to be back in there. I just thought I could just pull it up a wee bit, but happy to be in there, and that's it.
That's your pro debut.
Yep.
There was obviously, you were meant to fight, was it November last year?
Yeah.
I don't know if you want to reiterate that, what was the reasoning behind why you didn't fight last year? And
just 2016, something happened at Ricard and all that kind of malarkey, and they wanted typical boxing thing. No, and they wanted all the medical records, so everything we were giving them kept getting knocked back, and kept denying my license, so that's how we didn't fight, but I got all sorted, just happy to be here. And that's me fighting.
That's your fight. How long have you been out the ring?
About 18, 19 months now, so.
It's been a long time, isn't it?
Quite a while at the ring, so just happy to be back in there. It's like my second home, so
well, good to be back. Well, you said you're happy to be back in there, so how do you assess your performance then? I mean, you said you went to play, you know how you could perform.
I know how I can perform it, but these boys just don't want to do it, and so they're just trying to tie you up. So they're just there to frustrate you because they know they're not going to get the win, so they're just trying to make you frustrated. So I just had to keep my composure and let it go, but I wasn't happy with my shot selection and stuff, but these things happen.
Well, again, it's a learning curve. You got the win.
That's
you want to know as a pro.
Yeah.
I mean, like, a lot of people want to go out and get the stoppage and that, but sometimes getting the four rounds under your belt is more valuable than getting blown a guy out on the first
round. No, we spoke about that. We did say we weren't going to blow him out the water. What kind of credit do you get taking a tournament out? Do you know what I mean? It's not really. You know what I mean? Nobody's going, he took a gun. Do you know what I mean? So we were going to try to get the rounds under the belt and practice on the shots we've been working on. So I'm just happy we got in there, got it done, that's it.
You're back in the ring, there's no 18 month layoff. So when's your next out then?
We're going to have to find out, speak to Danny and that, and see when he wants me out again, hopefully as soon as possible. I want to be an active pro and out fighting all the time.
Well, how many fights do you want this year? I mean, we're in March, what are you looking for?
I would aim for five. Yeah, I'll aim for that. See what they were saying.
Well, with MTK, you're not just going to be fighting in Scotland. They could put you in any of the shows up and down the country.
So, yeah, I'm willing to travel.
You happy to go to Belfast, Manchester?
Listen, that's where I want to go, do you know what I mean? I'll travel. I want to be a household name everywhere, do you know what I mean? I want people to know, back in Ireland or here, or anywhere they want to send me, I want to be known, do you know what I mean?
So, what's the ambitions then, Jack? What are you aiming for? I'm not just going to say the whole program, your whole career, when you end the career, like the end of 2019, what are you hoping for?
We'll see how it goes. I mean, I would love to have a title by the end of the year. Do you know what I mean? Now that I'm in the mix, I've got myself in there, and I'm 1-0. I've experienced the whole thing, so I know how it kind of semi works now. So I definitely would like maybe a shot at something by the end of the year. Do you know what I mean? But I'll see what MTK
will do.
What
are you going to
be? Super Bantam.
Super Bantam.
I will be Super Bantam. Good weight.
Good weight
to be here.
Especially domestically,
aren't you? Exactly. So I'm gay, I'll fight anybody, do you know what I mean? That's how it is. If you're in here in the sport to do it, then
you mentioned that you know how to do it now, you got that one out of the way. What's the main differences in from the amateur days? Because I've watched you in the Scottish quite a few times. I know how good you are.
Yeah.
But it's okay for me saying how good you are and all that, but it's the people watching, isn't it? So what's the main difference between the pro?
It's a lot slower. I thought it was dead. Your punch selection was a lot more varied. I felt the pace was a bit slower. Didn't think it was as high tense, but what I noticed was every shot kind of counts that you throw. You feel everything for the catching a shot, you still bone glance, you feel it. So it's, I feel like, I would say
you're
going to
take a couple more fights to adapt it?
Or I think I'll need one more and I'll be at. Like, even at that, I feel like I can adapt it, no bother. Mm-hmm. Do you know what I mean? I've kind of got that. I can adapt to things, and I'll go back and work with my coach and we'll work from that fight. But I do feel it's a lot slower and your punch output is a wee bit less. So I have to kind of up that. I felt mine was a lot lesser than that. As I said, but that boy was a journeyman, so he was just looking to survive, so he wasn't throwing much.
Mm-hmm. So well, that's what I keep saying to people, like, if nobody's coming with the same ambition, there's not going to be any gaps, no one's going to throw punches, they're just going to turtle up. And when you're throwing 5-6 punches, they're turtling, they come back with a haymaker. So
that's it.
Are you going to speak to Danny, maybe with your team as well, maybe get a little guy with a little bit more ambition?
Definitely. Someone that's willing to open up so we can let our shots go as well, do you know what I mean? Definitely that. He was just awkward and just wanted to hold and hit me with a few heaters, so that was that.
You said you're camping at Super Bantam, mate. That Celtic title was vacant.
Yeah.
I think Tyrone McCullough's vacated that.
Yeah.
Speaking to him the other day. So that title you might be aiming for the end of the year.
Definitely, man, I'd love that.
You know, I'm IFL TV, we need a call out, we need names, we need everything like that, so anything.
I'll fight anybody who wants to put out, do you know what I mean? I'll fight absolutely anybody. I don't care who it is, it's Super Batman, that's just me, I'll fight anybody. But then that's up to my team to guide me properly.
If I like to see, I always go for like every Scottish fighter should wear a tartan on the shirt. So good to see you got the old dog there in the camera. Tartan on the shirt, I like it. Won't keep you much longer. There's a lot of guys that want to speak to you as well. I see the main man over there, my MTK, he wants to speak to you. So
nice,
I'll let you get on, I'll let you get the wraps
thank
on. Thanks for this 5-4 TV.
Thank
cheers,
you.
Jack.